Welcome back. When we last saw Mario, he had just submarined his way onto Euphoria Island, and here it is. Perry, an umbrella, ran off to go celebrate. What? No, it probably wasn't the best thing to say. Not because you're a jinx, just because it's terrible writing. Speaking of which, I have to apologise because a lot of this video is cutscene. It has to be done sometime though, so just be thankful we're getting it over with now, alright? Ah, the Chateau d'Or. French because Stephen is just that pretentious. It means Castle of Gold, which, if you were paying attention in part 1, should clue you into just whose castle it is. Plus 3 Mary Sue points for being described as beloved and magnificent in the same box. Okay, the first half of this cutscene here is a recap of SMW 2 plus 2. See you on the other side. Ah, so many questions. First, if you shattered the star when K-Mac already had it, how the hell did you end up with the pieces? Secondly, if you hid the star pieces to protect them from evil, why, now that evil is attacking, do you want them all gathered in one place again? And third, why does everyone identify you as a person of pure goodness when you punish thieves by giving them hideous deformities? Well, the answer to three is obviously Mary Sue, but I don't expect any actual answers for any of these. It was mentioned that Professor Frankly was the one who researched the star, so let's go check him out. Thank you. So, some guy called Roth found the Essence Star. The Essence Star is basically the Triforce. The Celestial Tower is very definitely the final dungeon. Frankly hates his wife, and there are 15 collectible cards to, well, collect. Let's check out the festival now, shall we? Holy crap, that's some pretty strong string holding those balloons completely still. And this is the item shop. Buying items from here is pretty much the only way to get items in your reserve box at the top of your screen, because remember, picking them up doesn't do jack. Remember back in part 1 whenever I said the coins were really important? Well, that's because some levels have keyhole exits, but no levels actually have keys. You have to buy all the keys from here. I really don't like how Luigi's trying to make this Jinx thing stick either. Back outside, and this is a fortune shop ran by Fawful, a character from the Mario and Luigi series. Specifically, he's an evil henchman in Superstar Saga and the main villain of Bowser's Inside Story. All the shop itself does is generate a random sarcastic fortune cookie. This is Goombario. You may remember him as your very first party member in Paper Mario if you've ever played that. You vs. Boo is a racing minigame which is sort of fun but tires after a while because its main purpose seems to be to grind coins. And now it's time for our first challenge titled Cameo Fetish. We're starting off with a simple little trivia challenge. All you have to do is tell me who that woman is and what game she was first in. Answers by 4 PM within 72 hours of this video going up, and because it's early days and I'm feeling generous, a point for everyone who gets it right. And the last thing in the festival is Level Up, which is essentially just a few bonus levels. The fourth and final one is currently locked though, so who knows what secrets lie within. Anyway, now that we're done here, we can finally go, oh my god! Now that we're done here, we can finally go to the ships. Five ships means there are five worlds we can go to, and we can go do them in whatever order I want. Join us next time when we'll finally get started with the actual game. It's very exciting.